Hi there, Doug Stewart with IT Creations. I thought I might give you the quick and dirty on the Intel Xeon 6 processor. Intel has been rapid firing new CPUs lately. Fourth generation Sapphire Rapids, Intel Xeon Scalable processors were released not even 2 years ago in January of 2023. That same year, in December of 2023, the fifth generation Emerald Rapids, Intel Xeon Scalable CPUs were released. And then another 6 months later, in June of 2024, they released Intel Xeon 6 CPUs, codename Sierra Forest. If you like our channel, hit that subscribe button, shall we? Just a reminder, the fourth gen Intel Xeon Scalable processors support up to 60 physical cores and 120 virtual threads. Well, and then there's the Max series at up to 56 cores and 112 virtual threads. Fifth gen Intel Xeon Scalable CPUs kicked it up a notch with support for up to 64 physical cores and 128 virtual threads. To be specific, that would be with the Platinum series processors. Lots of different frequencies and architecture tweaks for use with specific applications. Now we have Intel Xeon 6 offering performance cores and efficient cores, but no mixing, like they have done with the Intel's Core and Core Ultra CPUs. Granted, those are more consumer-based CPUs. With those, you get P-cores, E-cores, and low-power E-cores, or LPE cores, all in one package. That's not the case with the Intel Xeon 6, at least not yet. To date, this is the fourth quarter of 2024. Designed for enterprise, AI, data centers, cloud, and edge computing environments, the Intel Xeon 6 processor family includes the 6500, 6700, and 6900 series processors, offering significant upgrades across two performance levels, E-cores and P-cores. But again, no mixing of those E-cores and P-cores. For the record, Intel Xeon 6700 series CPUs were the first to be released and offer up to 144 cores and 144 virtual threads. That's a lot of cores. Intel Xeon 6 6700 series CPUs E-cores are physically smaller and more energy efficient than their P-core counterparts, so you can cram more of them into the CPU die, but they do use the same socket. They may not support hyper-threading, but they do support single-threading. P-cores, on the other hand, do support hyper-threading technology. Need some CPUs? Maybe some GPUs? Memory, storage, little bits to make your system whole again? Or maybe you need a whole system custom configured to your specifications. Try IT Creations. Chances are we have what you're looking for. And if you are looking, click that link right there for all your server, professional workstation, or random parts needs. ITCreations.com. With Intel hyper-threading technology, there are two virtual cores for each physical core. With single threading, there is one virtual core for each physical core. Efficiency cores, or E-cores, excel at managing background tasks that require less power, making them ideal for energy-conscious operations. With that reduced power usage, we're talking a much smaller carbon footprint, plus a 3-to-1 rack consolidation. Think data center applications. For every 3 racks of servers, you can knock that down to 1. However, that stat provided by Intel compares Intel Xeon 6 6700E processors to second-gen Intel Xeons, just to be clear. That said, they do offer dramatically increased core counts even over 5th-gen CPUs. On the other hand, Intel Xeon 6 6700P processors with P-cores support up to 86 physical cores and 172 virtual threads. Remember, the physical size of the E-cores are smaller than the physical size of the P-cores. That may be why there are only 86 P-cores compared to 144 E-cores. 6700P processors are engineered for high performance, featuring impressive clock speeds and support for hyper-threading. They're suited for demanding tasks that require a lot of processing power. Although P-cores and E-cores are optimized for different workloads, they share a compatible architecture. Intel Xeon 6 6900 series processors with P-cores offer maximum performance with 128 physical cores and 256 virtual threads, plus a maximum TDP of up to 500 watts. 6900P processors are ideal for the most demanding cloud, AI, high-performance environments. P-core versions that can be deployed in both single and dual socket servers, accommodating a 12-channel memory architecture for higher memory density than their 6500, 6700 counterparts with only 8-channel memory architecture. Additionally, P-cores provide up to 96 PCI 5.0 lanes for more expansion options and 6 Intel UltraPath interconnects, or UPI 2.0 links, for improved CPU to CPU communication bandwidth. As far as workloads, those CPUs with P-cores also include an integrated matrix engine to enhance AI performance computing and analytics workloads. With expanded core count, you get enhanced computing abilities, which does have an effect on high-performance computing aspect. The P-Core CPUs support DDR5 registered memory modules and multiplexer combined ranks dual inline memory modules, or MCR DIMMs. Just to make it more confusing, they're also referred to as multi-capacity rank dual inline memory modules, or MR DIMMs. I'm going to use MCR DIMMs for now instead of switching back and forth. Supported DDR5 memory offers speeds of up to 6400 megatransfer per second. MCR DIMMs, also DDR5, can reach data transfer rates of up to 8800 megatransfer per second, but are only used with one DIMM per channel and only with P-Core CPUs. MCR DIMMs are kind of like stacking two DIMMs on top of each other to access two memory ranks at the same time on a single channel. There are high-profile versions for a taller 2U chassis, or taller, and low-profile versions for a 1U application. With better utilization of memory channels, they deliver 37% greater memory bandwidth than DDR5 RDIMMs. Similarly, the 6900 series processors with E-cores can handle up to 288 cores and 288 threads, also with a TDP of up to 500 watts. They deliver more than 2.6 times the performance of second-gen Intel Xeon Scalable processors, making them a viable option for data-intensive applications. I mean, don't worry that we skipped over the third, fourth, and fifth generations. That's just the way Intel presented the information. Clearly a little marketing manipulation. Like their P-Core counterparts, E-Core CPUs are designed for single or dual socket server configurations with a 12-channel memory architecture. Intel says E-Core CPUs can replace 4 second-gen Intel Xeon Scalable CPU-based servers with a single server at similar performance. However, E-Core CPUs exclusively support DDR5 RDIMMs running at speeds of up to 6400 megatransfer per second and do not support MCR DIMMs. I suppose this could change. Remember, this is the fourth quarter of 2024. They also provide up to 96 PCI 5.0 lanes and UPI 2.0. Intel Xeon 6 6500 and 6700 series processors offer a significant upgrade to established Intel server platforms. They too are available with either P-cores or E-cores, but not both at the same time. Supported workloads include AI, web, microservices, plus networking and media. The P-core level supports up to 86 cores and 172 virtual threads with a maximum TDP of 350 watts. Those processors can be installed in 1, 2, and 4 and 8 socket servers, all supporting an 8-channel memory architecture. With DDR5 memory, speeds of up to 6400 megatransfers and up to 8000 megatransfers per second for MCR DIMMs. The P-cores deliver exceptional performance. They also provide up to 88 PCI 5.0 lanes with single socket CPU design configurations, offering up to 136 PCI lanes, plus support for 4 Intel UPI 2.0 links. 65 and 6700 CPUs with E-core processors can handle up to 144 cores and 144 threads with a TDP of up to 330 watts. Those CPUs are designed for single or dual socket systems, also supporting an 8-channel memory architecture. While E-core CPUs do not support MCR DIMMs, they can operate DDR5 memory modules at speeds of up to 6400 megatransfers per second. Additionally, E-cores offer up to 88 PCI 5.0 lanes and support 4 Intel UPI 2.0 links. That would be 8 less PCI lanes and 2 less UPI 2.0 links for CPU to CPU communications compared to the 6900 series. I will also mention there is an Intel Xeon 6300 series CPU, but that one specifically targeted at small and medium-sized businesses and an entry-level performer. There is a paltry amount of information for that series, unfortunately. I'm just gonna leave it at that. Boy, thought I would keep it short and sweet, which didn't go quite as planned. But if you still have questions, I posted a link to Intel's Xeon 6 product brief, which does go into the nitty-gritty. Systems supporting these processors are already out, at least with support for 6700E series. So as they say in Looney Tunes,
that's all, folks.
Hope we will get a whole system in soon for review. Subscribe to our channel if you want notifications when we release a new video. If you are looking for hardware, check out itcreations.com. Until next time, I'm Doug Steumann with IT Creations, and thanks for watching.